There are cities that have never been rebuilt after the bombing of the Second World War, or, for example, badly rebuilt. It's the case of Palermo. Let's go to see. In Sicily, most of the cities are disintegrating. Buildings that have been preserved for centuries seem destined to disappear very quickly. Walking around parts of Palermo and seeing so many totally dilapidated buildings remind me of Sarajevo.
Crollata a seguito dell'implosione delle due palazzine vicine.
The worst is the existence of power of a rapacious mafia-connected real estate, developers and construction companies. They have no hesitation to destroy ancient landmarks and replace them with architectural atrocities. Until a few years ago, Palermo's historical center was largely without residents. After the bombings of World War II, it was left to crumble. While the rest of Italy, historical centers were renovated and brought back to life. Between the 1950s and 1980s, the mafia ravaged Palermo. Many of the beautiful Art Deco buildings that epitomized the aesthetic of the city were destroyed. Some without permission in the middle of the night. Parks with paved over and uninviting apartment buildings, some with faulty construction, became mark of the city. The center ended up depopulated and without life. During the 1950s and 60s, an abnormal building expansion known as the Sacco di Palermo upset the architectural character of the city. As a Palermo's public war commissioner and briefly mayor, the infamous Vito Ciancimino gave thousands of buildings permits to unsavory characters, typically mafia frontmen. With the collaboration of several other politicians, Ciancimino and his ilk managed to turn a large part of Palermo into ugly concrete jungle, in the process to destroying historical buildings to erect new ones. The wider construction was, in many cases, parable to Cosa Nostra, Sicilian mafia. Business interests and produce 10 or more story concrete buildings. Some 19th century Liberty-style houses were demolished. Entire districts and important historical monuments were literally destroyed to make space for the new buildings. A clear example is Villa Deliella, built in 1905, was designed by the architect Ernesto Basile, an exponent of Art Nouveau and neoclassical movements. It once stood in the middle of the small park in what is now Piazza Croce, next to Palermo's English Garden, as a residence of the Deliella noble family, for Anita Drogo di Petiaperzia and Niccolò Lanza, a branch of Lanza Branciforte family. It was completed between 1907 and 1909 by the builder Salvatore Rutelli. The furnishings were done by Studio Duplo. In the 1954, the Department of Cultural Heritage of the Sicilian region has banned the villa as one of the works of Basile. However, the municipality of Palermo revoked it as the 50 years had not passed formally since its completion. In 1959, a variant of Palermo master plan allowed the construction of the area of the Via Libertà, where the Liberty private residence built between the late 19th and early 20th century were concentrated. The so-called Sacco di Palermo took place. Plans to demolish the Villa Deliella were submitted to the city council with the agreement of the last owner Franco Lanza di Scalea, and were happily approved to avoid the constraint of the cultural assets. In 1959, the city council authorized its destruction. And the demolition was carried out during the Saturday night. Yes, at night. In November 28th, in protest, Basile's son, Giovanni Battista, also accomplished architect, resigned from the Public War Commission. However, the permits for the new buildings were no longer issued, and today, an abusive parking and a car wash occupy the space where the villa once stood. not no more. In less than 20 years, historical and cultural monuments as Villino Sandro Ranieri, Genoa di Cavarretta, by architect Palazzotto, De Villino Silliti, Palazzo di Paola, Palazzo di Stefano, La Lumia, Palazzo Meio, De Villini, Nicoletti, Ricco Bono e Palazzo Gaeta, designed by Armand, also Villino Planeta and Palazzo Restivo, disappeared. The bad news is the most of Via Libertà cannot be saved. The villas, replaced by ugly apartment buildings, are gone forever. The good news is that the old historical center of the city is gradually being restored to something of its former glory. Now, I will take some pieces of this place. Back in Berlin, and I'm gonna make the ingot of Villa Deliella.